Their best offensive guy was Antonio Day. Their best defensive guy was Chuba Ohams. And kind of the heart and soul, the three people that embodied the mentality that Fordham was trying to play with were Ohams, Cologne Navarro, and Kyle Neptune. None of those guys are here anymore.
The quarterfinals is no small task, right? And to build off that would take another, I think, massive step that I don't know if you see coming. I don't know if I do this year.
These guys are cheering for a team that's going to finish 13th to 15th in the A-10. I'm going to be honest. They're fucking terrible.
I'm not kidding when I say this. Fordham don't know what to do in a basketball game. They are fucking losers. Fucking losers.
Work it, make it, do it. Makes us all the better, faster, stronger. That makes us stronger.
Back and down, puts it back. A huge charging foul against Forbes. Both fantastic. Trail Shelton on the take, off the fake and the lay-in. Leads the fast break. Richardson all the way, puts it in.
Tipped around, Moore comes up with it. Ball is loose, Sambila skies for it. Far wing, Zach Riley, put three!
This gym is on fire.
Throw in Nowitzki, double team. Now it's Antrell Charlton, 3 seconds on the shot clock. Mid-range jump shot, yes! Antrell Charlton, 0.3 seconds on the shot clock.
Every time he gets out there,
Quisenberry gets two more, and then I'll do it.
Inbound to Banks. And that'll do it. The Bonnies will fall at home by a final score of 79 to 68.
Another steal for the Rams. Up ahead to Moore. And he throws it down. Khalid Moore. Passing it up ahead to Moore. In transition, tomahawk slam at the buzzer. Gets another steal. Up ahead to Moore. It's showtime. Move to 17-4 and 5-3 in conference, 85-70 over George Washington here at the Rose Hill Gym. What a win for Fordham.
Some people are calling this game against St. Louis, who is first place in the A-10 Travis Ford squad, the biggest Fordham game in the last 15 years. Unfortunately for Fordham, I do not believe they're a top A-10 team. It's been a great run. I love that for them. But I've got St. Louis minus 4 tonight.
If we played them 10 times, they might win 9. Not this game. Not tonight.
I can't tell if that's sarcasm. Quisenberry the steal. Lays it in. It's a matchup we wanted to see all day. Sambila, able to take it away. Sambila! Slapped away, Sambila does it again, and he steps over the top. Such majority. Collins tipped away by Rose. They both spew to the floor. It is Fordham basketball. Second half. Moore, the number one team in the A-10 goes down, and Fordham knocks off St. Louis 75-65. Quisenberry, Moore, and one.
Steps back, takes a three, and he hits it! Darius Quisenberry for three!
Fordham is having their best season in the last 30 years. Thomas, down three. Leggett lets it go. No! And that's how it ends.
Evan D!
In the best Fordham season in recent memory. It's going to end with a 20-point win over Duquesne to clinch a double bye next week in Brooklyn.
Every day stretch that to around.
We want to be top three in the country. That's Coach Urban's, one of Coach Urban's main goals from last year. And I feel like that this team is capable of doing it. We're going to find the right pieces, and we're going to also continue to have confidence in each other and trust each other. And we're going to play with some type of swag this year because of what we established last year.
passing it long to Khalid Moore, catches it, drives towards the basket. The two-handed dunk at the buzzer.
Zbicki gives. Richardson for three. Richardson.
The left wing. 5 seconds on the shot clock. A three. And he hits it. And for the first time since 2006, Fordham is on to the semis. They take on Dayton Saturday afternoon, a 69-61 win over LaSalle in the quarterfinals. What a victory for the Rams.
How about Darius Quisbury putting the bow on this game? Didn't need to put that lap in, but all for style points down the stretch. Fordham, they close it out. Sam, you mentioned it. It wasn't easy. It wasn't pretty. But at the end of the day, all that matters for Fordham, all they care about is the W and moving on. A massive success. 25 wins on the season. You mentioned it, 11 in the preseason bowl. To just be in this position, right, in the semifinals in the Atlantic 10 and give Dayton everything you had, it's a feel-good story, one of the best in college basketball all season.